Hello, in this tutorial I will explain the controls to program a spaceship trajectory. When you have selected a planet or moon, you will see at the lower right of the screen the spaceship launch button. Tap it to enter into the spaceship design screen. Here you will find a lot of information. At the upper left of the screen, you will see the planet or moon from which the spaceship will be launched. You cannot change that, it's the object you had selected when tapping on the spaceship launch button. Next, to the right, you will see the destination star system. You can click there to select a different star system. Next you have the destination planet, which by default is the same planet the spaceship is going to launch from. You can change the destination planet by tapping on that button, which will cycle throughout all the planets in the selected star system. The last button is used to select the destination satellite. It only has effect when selected planet has moons. Tapping it will cycle throughout all moons from the selected planet. At the next line, the button at the left is used to select the type of the spacecraft to be launched. At the right of the screen, you will see an icon of the selected spaceship, which is also clickable. In the same line, the button at the right is for selecting the mission of the spaceship, which can be either landing on the planet or moon, or entering into a stable orbit. Landing mission is disabled when destination is the same as the origin, or when destination object has an irregular surface. Just below this button, you will see an icon of the selected mission, which is also clickable. When launching into orbit of the same planet, you will see an inclination slider to select the inclination with respect to the equatorial orbit. When mission is selected to orbit a planet or moon, you will see an altitude slider to select the altitude of the final orbit. When not launching into orbit of the same planet, you will see a logarithmic slider with the value of delta V for the selected trajectory. This will have a default value depending on the type of the spacecraft and the selected trajectory, but it can be changed manually. Minimum and maximum values will also depend on the trajectory and the specific impulse of the spacecraft. After all parameters have been selected, tap on the launch button to start the trajectory. Interplanetary trajectories require a correct alignment of the planets, so in some cases, you will have to wait a lot of time before the spaceship launches. You can see the countdown to launch at the upper right of the screen. You could use the time slider to accelerate time until you approach the launch date, but when you are waiting for launch, a specific fast-forward button will appear at the upper right of the screen to do that for you. You can tap it and it will automatically manage the time slider until you get to the launch date. After the spaceship has launched, an icon will appear on the spaceship position. That icon can be seen even if the camera is located far away from the spaceship, although sometimes it can be hidden by the planet's surface. After you have located the spaceship icon, you can tap on it to select the spaceship. Tap it again to zoom into the spaceship. You will notice that the fuel tank in this spaceship is bigger than in the real shuttle. This is because I have selected an orbit to Mars, while the shuttle is designed to travel to Earth orbit. The size of the spacecraft will be adjusted depending on the calculated fuel requirements. When you have selected a spaceship, you will also see the fast forward button at the upper right of the screen. In this case, the button will automatically handle the time slider in order to produce a smooth transition between the phases of the trajectory. It can be useful when you want to see the whole trajectory in a short time without playing with the time slider. You can disable it at any time by tapping on it again. Using the cinematic mode button, you can have a more realistic view of the spaceship, like in a movie. You can zoom out of the spaceship at any time. When you get far enough, you will see the trajectory of the spaceship. After the spaceship lands on a planet, it will disappear and the planet will be selected. If the mission of the spaceship was to enter into orbit, it will stay indefinitely into its final orbit. You can have many spaceships into orbit at the same time. This concludes this tutorial. Check the other tutorials for additional information.